Welcome to Lazy Pete, guys. Let's get right into part one of the Alibaba setup tutorial video. I went through this whole process for a client on January 2nd, 2020, so everything you will see is updated and accurate as of that date. Please watch the first part of the video before setting up your account, the first part of this video. I'm assuming you're here for my expertise, and I'm sure you will make at least three very costly mistakes if you do not watch before setting up your account. Watch first. The first thing we will do is go to Alibaba.com. Now, depending on your computer's privacy settings, in your Safari or Chrome preferences interface, your screen should look something like this. If this is not the screen you are seeing, do not panic. If you have properly navigated to Alibaba.com, you need to look for a link that says Join Free, like this right here, under the Sign In button. After you click this link, you should see a page that looks like this. This begins the three-step process to establishing your Alibaba account. From my experience setting up my own account and dozens of accounts for various clients, I highly suggest that you create a brand new email to be used only for Alibaba.com. The first concern is privacy. Your email will get spammed to high heaven. So if you know that only suppliers, traders, and manufacturers from Alibaba are sending you emails, you will have an easier time managing your inbox and spam folder. The next concerns are convenience and expediency. As far as convenience, it's just easier to have a dedicated email for Alibaba. And as I will repeat later, expediency of messaging is very, very important. It can often be difficult to get a response in a reasonable time period on the site. So when a supplier responds to one of your emails, you should promptly reply. Your quick response also shows that you are a professional and, even more important than that, a serious customer. Okay, I had to get that part out of the way. That was very important. So now back to this step. After inserting your hopefully totally brand new dedicated email address, then you need to slide the button underneath it to the right to begin the verification process. Next, check the user agreement box below that and right here. Here is proof that you are watching the right channel to learn about this stuff. This bullet right here means that after checking this box that you are required to check if you want an Alibaba account, you have basically sold your soul to the spam demons. This should not be a deal breaker if you heed my advice and get a dedicated email. Now, hit the next button, and then this is the screen you should see. The Alibaba server is now sending you a confirmation email. Could take a few minutes. Press the Go Check mailbox and you will receive an email that looks something like this. This is the actual opened email from my client's inbox. Go ahead and press Complete. And keep in mind that this link is only valid for 24 hours. So here's the second time that you will benefit from having a brand new dedicated email account for Alibaba. You should see this email before 24 hours has elapsed. If your browser does not support pressing complete, just copy and paste the link below the button into your search bar and press enter. Okay, after you have completed the email verification and click the link in your email, you should be directed to this page. This is where you will select a password for your account and what type of business you are. I have created this video for people who wish to be buyers, but the setup is the same for suppliers as well. Now, this next part is also extremely important. Right here, where they ask you for your name, you must use your legal name. If you do not, you will have many problems in the future on this site. However, for company name, even though it says that you must have a legally registered company, from my experience, this is not the case. You can simply create a generic name for your brand or company and type it into this box. I should add, in the interest of transparency, this is what I did on Alibaba initially back in 2014 when I started on the site. But now I have my own legally registered LLC business. So I only changed the information that I had in this box after I could afford to start my LLC. Alibaba will not verify what you put in this box if you are a buyer, but if you plan to sell as a supplier or manufacturer, in the interest of prudence, you should plan the expense of becoming a totally legitimate, legally registered company. And now your telephone number. Do not use your main cell phone number on Alibaba. Do not use your home or office numbers either. You will regret it a million times over. I personally use Grasshopper, but there are a number of reliable services where you can pay about $10 a month or so to have a second phone line. This is very important, guys. When you're finished, hit confirm. Congratulations, you're all set up on Alibaba. And for some of you, this is where you can stop my video. But if I helped you at all, please like, subscribe, share, and comment. I would really appreciate it. For those of you who like my client, have never done anything like this before, please go to the video entitled Step-by-Step Alibaba Tutorial After Account Setup. I'm deliberately separating the second half of the setup process because some people look at videos, like the length of videos on YouTube, and see a longer video and automatically scroll past the best, most thorough tutorials on YouTube. In the second video, I will walk you through the all-important personal assistant, and I will also define and explain the most important terms you will need to be familiar with to start your empire. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you in the next video.